There has never been a time that God has forsaken. You know, she mentioned earlier, I'm 20 years old and I'm a young person by all means. But I like to tell people when they ask me about my testimony, I've lived a lot of life in the few years that I've been on earth. I've made mistakes and I've been through some things that not only matured me, but brought me closer to God in the end. I'm going to tell you a little bit about my testimony, or a story about my life. I was 18 years old, just 2 years ago, not that long ago. And I was a freshman at Bethel University. And I made some friends my very first semester, which is sometimes hard to do, but music was a common theme between all of us. We all loved music of all kinds. So we figured out that we all like bluegrass music, and we planned this trip to go to a bluegrass jamboree in Camden, Tennessee. Yeehaw. we had to use a GPS to get out there. It was like an hour and a half away from the school. We loaded up in my buddy's car, and we went. And when we went and had a good time, they even brought us up, and we put together a little scrap iron quartet and tried to sing the best we could of Nothing But the Blood. So we went, had a good time, and on the way back, we had to use GPS again, and because I fully believe that GPSs were made by the devil himself, it took us a completely different direction than it took us to get up there. So not only did we not know the route on the way there, we also didn't know the route on the way back because it sent us a different direction. So we were going down this road that we were unfamiliar with, going 55 miles an hour. Going 55 miles an hour. We got to the top of the hill, and there wasn't a sign at the top of the hill to let us know that there was a stop sign at the bottom of the hill. So we came down this hill going full speed. And by the time that the driver of the vehicle that I was in saw the stop sign, he was driving kind of an old car. He slammed on the brakes, but it kept rolling, and we rolled into oncoming traffic, got hit on the driver's side that me and the driver were sitting on by a pickup truck going 62 miles an hour. I had a bunch of injuries. The car slid and landed in the median. The guys on the passenger side were able to free themselves, get out, go get us help, but me and the driver were pretty banged up. So we got life-flighted to Vanderbilt in Nashville, Tennessee. And like I said, way too many injuries to list, but I'll tell you this one because it's a big part of the story. There's a ring at the bottom of your pelvis that basically connects your legs to your pelvis and holds everything together. Well, when we got hit, I did something with my legs to try to like brace myself, and it ended up tearing that ring. So it was torn in half and I couldn't walk for 6 months. I went back 6 months later for my 6 month checkup. They took an x-ray of my pelvis. And the guy that took the x-ray was the same guy that saw me when I came in 6 months prior. And he said, man, I'll just be honest with you. If I didn't see you then, and I didn't have all the paperwork that you were the same person, I wouldn't believe it. Because I saw you when you came in, and I told myself even then, he's not going to make it. But now I'm looking at these x-rays that we just took this morning, and you can walk out of this hospital if you want to. And because I'm stubborn and I don't like being pushed around in a wheelchair or just in life in general, I walked out of the hospital, and that's when my recovery and rehabilitation began.
Amen.
And it was during that time, they put me on a lot of pain medicine. I had a lot of internal injuries that you really wouldn't even notice if you were just looking external. Put me on a lot of pain medicine. And there'd be some times I'd wake up in the middle of the night and my ribs would be trying to heal back together, and my pelvis would be trying to heal back together, and I'd be in so much pain that I couldn't even move to reach my pain medicine on my dresser. Just pain, just so much pain that I had to just lay there and deal with it. And it lasted for 30 minutes sometimes. And it was during that time I would often question God and say, why is this happening to me? You know, why of all people this could have happened to, why am I the one going through this pain right now? And it's human nature to question God when you go through pain. But if you're going through pain here tonight, I'll tell you what I heard, and you can call it the Holy Spirit, or you can just call me crazy. But I heard God tell me, stop feeling sorry for yourself, because Jesus went through far more on the cross than you could ever go through down here on earth. And it's because of the cross that we are able to continue life and to have eternal life and to have it more abundantly while still on earth. Amen. It was a phone call that you feared, and it took your breath away. You are.